Morning. Can you please stand now and greet one another as we begin our celebration?
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace for our Lord Jesus Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
To celebrate these most sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins, all the times we have been aware of God's love and presence in our lives. We entrust ourselves, weak that we are, to his mercy and love made new this Mass.
You are near to all who call upon you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are holy in all your works. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are generous and forgiving. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his ways and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate towards all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him and to all who call upon him in truth. The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I am caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Open our hearts, O Lord, and listen to the words of your Son. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace. He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went again around noon and around 3, and did likewise. Going about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual wage. So when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. If what I wish to give is the last one the same as you,
Or am I not free to do so as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. That's the gospel point about ours.
In the first reading of Isaiah, it was said, "Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near." We must remember that God is always close to us, for we prayed in the psalm, "The Lord is near to all who call upon him. He does not move away from us. We often move far from him. For in bad times, we often even erect barriers. It is foolish to try to fit God into our mold, to make his plans and purposes conform to ours. Instead, we must strive to fit into his plans. It was proclaimed, 'For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways,' says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts." Human beings simply cannot control the reign of God. In God's reign, worth is determined simply by God's acceptance, God's giving grace. Remember that Jesus paid a debt he did not owe, because we owed a debt we could not pay. Hopefully, we do not begrudge God's generosity. I heard Father Chad asking the children during his homily at this last Wednesday's daily mass, "When you go to the store and give the cashier your money, do you expect to receive the candy you put on the counter? Or if mom and dad say, 'If you are good during the Sunday mass, you can have a donut afterwards,' if you are good, and do you expect that donut?" I'm sure you know the answer the children gave. What can our expectations regarding work and wages, welfare and unemployment, money and debt payment tell us about the kingdom of God? In the parable of the gospel, the laborers in the vineyard see the extraordinary generosity and compassion of God, the landowner. However, during these times, our expectations may be wavering, as we're experiencing the effects of the COVID pandemic, for example, with great tragedy and unemployment, the loss of work, or given an option of working at home with a pay cut, and the inability to earn enough to live and support oneself or even one's family. Hopefully, we're keeping the faith and realizing the dignity of the person involves the ability to work. For any work is more honorable than doing nothing. As the gospel parable asserts that wages do not determine the worth of an individual, all are equal and are equally needed in the vineyard at every hour of the day. In Jesus' time, laborers had to wait each day in the marketplace until someone hired them for a day's job. No work that day usually meant no food on the family table. In this gospel parable, the laborers who worked all day received their payment, complain that the master pays the late afternoon laborers the same wage. The master undoubtedly hired them in the late afternoon so they wouldn't go home payless and hungry. Jesus is addressing this parable to the Jewish people whom God, The landowner called at an early hour centuries ago and now is addressing the Gentiles and all of us today, whom are also being called with an equal right to form part of the new people of God, the church. It's a matter of gratuitous, unmerited invitation. Therefore, those who were first to receive the invitation have no grounds to complain when God calls the last and gives them the same reward, membership in his family. At first reading, the laborers who were first hired seemed to have a genuine grievance because they didn't realize that to have a job in the Lord's vineyard is a divine gift. Jesus leaves no doubt that although we may come by different paths, we all receive the same reward, the kingdom of heaven. We need to realize that to have a job in the Lord's vineyard is a divine gift. The Lord wants to fill each of us with the power and strength of the Holy Spirit so we can bear great fruit for God's kingdom, the fruit of peace, joy, righteousness, and love, and also bring the fruit of his kingdom to our neighbor as well. We labor for the Lord to bring him praise, honor, and glory, and we labor for our neighbor for their welfare with the same spirit of loving kindness and compassion which the Lord has shown us. From our parish bulletin mission statement, the mission of St. Gabriel, the Archangel Community, is to develop Christian disciples who spread the good news, serve others, and welcome all with care and compassion. St. Paul so eloquently reminds us from Philippians, only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. Lord Jesus, fill us with your Holy Spirit, that we may serve you joyfully and serve our neighbor willingly with a generous heart, not looking for how much we can get, but rather looking for how much we can give. Let our eyes always be raised up to you so that we may swiftly answer your call.
Stand. As children of our Heavenly Father, recognizing his goodness and generosity, let us offer in thanksgiving all he has done for us. I believe one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of Olive before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men, for our salvation, came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. Our Savior was crucified in Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures, ascended to heaven in heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, received from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism, forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Entrusting our hearts to our Father and the prayers that we hold, confidently hears our every prayer.
For all who have sought and found the Lord in His holy church, for those who are in the process of finding their way, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political and national leaders, for all who assist them in exercising their authority, may God open their hearts to His guidance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are unemployed or underemployed, and for those who seek to help them, may the Lord provide for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from physical and mental illness, may they be healed through God's infinite mercy and be comforted by those who care for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who cannot be physically present with us today in this sacred assembly, may the Lord's peace come upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly confirmed who have received the fullness of God's Spirit, that standing at the altar of the Lord, they may share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice, calling God their Father in the midst of the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Stephen and Pearl Walski, may the souls of all faithful departed be received into eternal life and peace of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Darrell August Larson, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the unspoken prayers that dwell within our hearts, may our compassionate God hear our prayers and grant us our needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we offer you each of these prayers, all the ones spoken and the ones we hold in silence for our hearts. And we ask you to grant them all according to your holy, perfect will for our lives. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, the God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, the God of all creation, for through your goodness we have seen this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept thy sacrifice.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs. Through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power working the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, Assistant Bishop, the old bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, a merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, let us dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, glory, and glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For all those who are at home, please know of our prayer for you, and we miss you, and we hope that, God willing, you're able to join us soon, but let us all pray for an end again of this pandemic so we can all worship as one body again. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Father of all mercy, giver of all life, here we speak our covenant above the